I have three different names people call me. My nickname there is Batman. My drag name is Nevaeh, and my real name is Donovan. So, really, I get called any of those, and I answer to all three of them. You never would think that you could answer to three different names like that, but it happens. But really, I always tell people, because I know a lot of times with shows and people approach you and they haven't ever been to a show, they're like, do I say he? Do I say she? For me, I say if I'm dressed as a woman and I'm presented to you as a woman, she. If I'm presented to you as a man, he. That's my general way of doing things. Actually made my first handmade drag outfit, and this is now on film, but my dad said he never wanted anyone to know, but everyone knows now. I was so to me I was so proud of that moment. I was like, don't ever be embarrassed by that. Like, that is amazing that you were willing to do this, that you were so accepting of me, that like you're gonna get on a sewing machine and put together an outfit for me.
My parents left me when I was still in high school. They decided they wanted a life of their own without children, and they got a secret house with like a swimming pool and like everything in New York. They moved, and I had not started my senior year yet. I had to just kind of figure it out, and this is where they left me. So, but they're back, and we're good, and yep.
We actually have a very, very talented group of individuals in the amateur scene. And I mean, even in my home, I live with
You're
two
not
drag
alone. They
queens
didn't
and
press
a
that thing.
DJ and a drag
Yeah,
promoter.
everybody
So it's
was
like a drag
affected for a long
house.
time. Oh,
It's
that's
just a
weird. Where is
thing.
it at then?
It's gone because everybody used
Oh,
it.
weird.
When I was 18, they had drag shows in Owosso at one of the bars. Every month they did a drag show. Honestly, it was before I even came out. I had a couple of my friends, they're like, we want to go to this drag show. I'm like, okay, cool, whatever, we'll go. And I started watching it and just, I fell in love with it. It was entertaining, it was funny. Just to watch all these crazy outfits and not know what's gonna come next, or like to see, a 6 foot drag queen in stilettos doing cartwheels and back bends, and I'm like, wow, like this is entertaining.
I actually did not want to be a drag queen. I wanted to be like a David Bowie, Marilyn Manson, rock star type. And I used to like go to goth clubs. Even in high school, I would wear costumes to school. I just didn't know what it was I was doing. And everybody was like, oh, you're like a drag queen. And I was like, no, I'm not a drag queen. I'm like androgynous. I still think that is in my drag. But one day, I work in a lot of haunted houses, and they're like, we need you to fill in a role for a girl that plays like this crazy kitchen lady. And I was like, oh, I don't do drag. And they're like, just do it, like, you'll have fun. And I did it, and then I was like, oh my God, I wanna like do this, do this.
I never thought about drag, I never thought about DJing, I never thought about working in nightclubs. It was never something that I wanted to do. I wanted to go to art school, I wanted to be a painter. So I was at the nightclub one night when I was like 18 years old, and the bar manager there wanted to fire the DJ because he wasn't bringing in people. And he saw that I had a lot of friends, and he said, hey Roger, do you want to be a DJ? And I said, sure. And he said, get up there and fake it till you make it. So that's what I did. I've built a whole career and a brand, and I'm 13 years in, and it's just been great for me. And it's life kind of throws you opportunities, and it's up to you to take them.
Starting drag, it opened me up so much in general. I was always the extremely shy person. I don't say nothing to nobody. I'm really quiet. I decided I love dancing in general. I would go to the bar and I'll dance by myself the whole night. No problems. That just what I like to do. And so when I first started seeing drag shows, I was like, I want to try that. I want to do that. And so I did it. And the more I did it, the more my comfort zone grew. It was like a whole new mindset. And you throw on the wig and the heels and you become the other person. It's literally just changing who you are. I'm no longer Donovan, I'm now Nevaeh.
There is this side of gay culture, the middle finger to like straight people, heteronormative society, I guess. And that's where my drag comes from, is like that world of like, kind of saying like, fuck you to gender. I feel like drag really just shows that we're all human beings and that everything we do is just so made up. You know, and it's just kind of like breaking that illusion of like, these clothes make you a boy, these clothes make you a girl. You know, it's like, that's silly.
Some people, you know, use drag as a means to be accepted because they never were. And some people, you know, use drag as a means to project their art form. And, you know, drag can come from a great place, but drag a lot of times comes from really ugly places and really dark places and people's childhoods and, you know, even adulthoods. And it's great that something so positive can come out of something so negative.
I actually have Frankenstein tattooed. Because I feel like Frankenstein is like the most misunderstood monster. In a way, I feel like that's almost saying that that's what it's like to be gay. You feel like you were made wrong, and you feel like people treat you like an abomination because of it. And it's like, you're not made wrong, you are who you are.
A lot of people think they know in their mind what a drag queen is. So when they see drag queens, they're like, oh, this is the type of person you are because you're a drag queen. Not everyone's the same. Not everyone's overly flamboyant. There's nothing against it. Some people are. That's them.
What people forget about is trans women don't necessarily all do drag. And not all drag queens are trans women.
It's cool to live here because you get all these different personalities coming at each other, and it all works out. That's the other weird thing about drag. Is you find out who these people are out of drag, and you're like, oh, I would probably never be friends with that person out of this kind of life if they didn't do drag.
We get in fights. We have our issues, and, you know, people bicker, but that's family in general. There's no family that's super happy all the time.
Shut up. you know, it's... You have so many personalities, and we're lucky for the most part we all get along. Every once in a while we'll fight, but it's usually we're just bickering at each other over...
But at the end of the day, we all love each other. We all take care of each other.
You know, I just told Donovan the other day, I was like, it doesn't matter if we fight or not, or if I'm mad at you. Like, if you ever need me, I'll be there. If you're stuck on the side of the road, I'll be there. If you need to borrow money, I'll be there. And that's kind of like what we do for each other, you know?
Having that small family of even just the amateur queens that know how to do different pieces and being able to work with each other and help each other out in that aspect. It's been great.
You know, it's definitely a place that they can come. It's a safe space. People come here to learn how to do makeup, and people come here for costuming, or sometimes we'll do photos. So it's a really great dynamic, because I was just having a conversation with one of my friends who used to live here in Lansing, and we were talking about how it's come full circle, because 13 years ago when I started, there was a house full of drag queens that are now all huge in the industry. They all started together. So we were talking about how it's come full circle, and now we have that house.
I'm seeing a lot more political numbers. I've done numbers where I rip Trump flags on stage. I've seen people do a number where they, like, smash the TV with Trump on it. Politics today in our culture has impacted everything.
Oh, is this what we're... I didn't vote.
I didn't either, though.
Okay, good.
Why didn't you vote? That's such a terrible thing to say.
It's your fault, Jesse.
I think that everybody had a different reaction. I remember when the president got elected, we were all at a small bar called The Avenue here in Lansing. Everybody was just silent. Like, it was just so surreal that it had actually happened.
But the politics nowadays and where we're at, as far as, you know, the Trump campaign and the government in general, it's a really weird time, to be honest. Because in one hand, you have a political group that is attacking all minority communities, not just gay community, but all of them. And at the same time, we're also in a time in society where RuPaul's Drag Race is on VH1. It's a really weird time, because as much as we have so much more than our past has had in the gay community, at the same time, don't have everything.
So I think the gay community and the drag community is always going to push forward regardless of...
Absolutely.
I mean, Stonewall, where drag queens, I mean, really come from. It was all political activism.
Yeah.
And that's always going to be the underlying message in a lot of people's drag.
Research what it is to do drag. Make sure your motives of doing drag are correct. Not just because it's popular. Learn what it is to be a drag queen, where it came from. Do your history on Stonewall and any of the people who have done this before you. What I would tell someone who doesn't know about the drag community and do come with their own preconceived judgments is to open their mind. Ask. The best thing you can do in life is educate yourself before you make your own judgment. If you aren't educated, you shouldn't be judging. And most drag queens, we love talking to people. If you have questions or you want to know why or what or whatever, just ask. We're going to tell you. We're all humans at the end of the day. And I mean, most drag queens, not all drag queens, most drag queens, at the end of the day, we come home, it all comes on.
A lot of people's drags, in one way or another, might not be direct.
I think it's my Cody powder.
I don't know
who's Cody powder.
Oh my god, probably.
Justin, we're all can't really pretend like we share.
Sorry.
Are you stressed out?
I'm always stressed.
Do you want me to hand you some makeup so you can pretend to do something?
Something. Are you like a palette?
Where's your foundation? Just put your foundation on.